Deadly Premonition is best described as a sanity-be-damned romp into the mind of one of Japan's most unrestrained video game creators.
Pure, unadulterated entertainment.
It's a good thing they took a research trip to the Pacific Northwest. I think they really captured some idiomatic sense of being in America.
If you can explain what's happening in Deadly Premonition, you haven't been paying attention enough.
It's a product of a sick and twisted individual.
Kind of scary, sometimes unintentionally so.
I really like that his raincoat automatically comes on when it's raining.
He's paying $99 for a turkey sandwich.
Oh, the controls.
The controls are pretty bad.
Dreamcast quality graphics.
It may not be the most technically proficient game I've ever played, but it's the most unforgettable.
It has a lot of technical polish in areas you might not expect, like in rendering sweaty, fat man saliva.
There's this girl in Deadly Premonition, this female monster, and she will, like, stick her hand down your throat when she tries to attack you. I don't know, that's awesome.
More games need to say, you know what?
It's the best open-world, third-person, survival horror action-adventure game I've ever played.
You can kind of walk around town and, like, peek in windows and just watch people doing their everyday life activities. That's really creepy, and that's awesome.
This is a game from a very creative, visionary director from Japan, and I'm honestly super excited to see what he does next.
You know, he brews his creations with a funky, fishy flavor, and it percolates straight from his heart.
Game design in the coffee.
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 Game design in the coffee.